Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana, and today we're going to talk about a new tool that I've been using to kind of help keep track of things that I need to do and things that I need to remember. So this is a web-based program that we're kind of excited about, and it's called Workflowy, which is W-O-R-K-F-L-O-W-Y. And basically, it's a website that allows you to write down thoughts, keep track of them, search them later, make to-do lists, and all those kind of things. So what we're going to do is on this Mac here, we're going to show you how to create a basic Workflowy list, and then we're going to show you how you can also get access to it on your iPad. So what I've done is I've gone to workflowy.com, and because I'm already logged in, it's going to bring up my blank page here where I have work items and I have personal items, and I'm going to add a new item here and I'm going to call it gardening. And let's say that we were sitting down and planning to do some things related to gardening, and I want to have a salsa garden, and inside of my salsa garden I want to have tomatoes, let me spell that right, I want to have onions, I want to have cilantro, I want to have peppers, and I want to have chilies, and I also want to have jalapenos. I gotta spell that right too. And so I can go and make these lists, and I can indent things that belong to subcategories and all those kind of things, and then I can go back and put tags on them. So let's say I want to go into each one of these and tell it that this is a gardening item, and I can put that on each one of those. And after a while it learns what my tags are, so I don't even have to type the whole thing. And I'm going to stop here. I would probably go in and tag all those things. And let's say these are things I know I need to buy. I need to have tomato plants and those kind of things. So I could also put in buy, or I could put purchase. Let's say that I want to call each one of these something I need to purchase. And so what happens then is after I tag these items, I collapse my list back down. So now that I have a gardening list there, and I can go into Workflowy and I can expand things and shrink them down so I can see as much or as little as the things that I need to do. And then later I can go back and search for those things. So I can put in the word onion and it'll find anywhere in my list, including the fact that we have French onion dip on our shopping list here, it'll find the word onion. I can also go in here and click on those tags and it'll bring up anything that has those tags. I can also even add people to these lists. So I could put in here that Ann and I are going to work on a garden, and then maybe later I need to have an item where I can say Ann needs to film our tech tip, and that's who's helping us today. And then when I go back to find those people, I can search by people's names and bring up the names of the people who are going to be involved in these things. The thing that I really like about Workflowy is it's very easy to have on your computer, and if you're having a meeting and you're taking notes, you can say things like the first person said, and then you can have item one, and then they said item two. And it's a very free-flowing thing that once you get used to doing, it can help you take notes of all kinds of things and then later search for them, and you can even get them on your iPhone or your iPad. And what I've done here is my iPad's been running the whole time, but you'll see that while we've been doing this, it's updated. And here's my gardening list, and I can also search for things that have the tag gardening in them. And so it updates this list on my computer when I update it, my iPhone, or my iPad, and that works both ways. There are times when I'm at the grocery store and I have my shopping list that I have created on my computer, but then I'm checking items off when I go and get cereal and milk and those kind of things. So this doesn't work very well with a screen reader, unfortunately. We've done a little accessibility testing there, and I think it has a way to go, but for folks who just need reminders for lists, taking notes, keeping records, and those kind of things, it's a pretty cool service. The basic version is free. If you use it extensively, it costs, I think, about $50 a year, which is a fairly reasonable cost, I think, for that kind of assistance. So that's Workflowy, W-O-R-K-F-L-O-W-Y.com, and that's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.